Patients ask me all the time, what is sex and what is intercourse going to be like after I have surgery, radiation, cryo, et cetera? Is it going to work and how is it going to feel? And I think it's a great question. So let's talk a little bit about the details. Number one is that after surgery and routinely after radiation or even cryoablation, for a man, when he ejaculates, very little fluid will come out, okay? And here's the issue, is that after we take the prostate out, we'll talk about the robotic prostatectomy first. After the prostate has been removed, when a man ejaculates, no fluid will come out. Well, why is that? Let's talk about what the fluid actually consists of. 10% of the fluid, give or take, actually comes from the testicles, from the vas deferens. So 10% is roughly sperm. The other 90% actually comes from the prostate and the seminal vesicles. So when we actually do the robotic prostatectomy, we not only take the prostate out, as well as those small little areas in the back called the seminal vesicles, but we actually also do a vasectomy at the same time, because the vas deferens actually insert towards the back side, you know, along with the ejaculatory duct actually in the prostate. So we actually do all of that. So when a man ejaculates, no fluid will come out. But ejaculation is different than orgasm. And they're different for a number of different reasons. When a man reaches orgasm, he gets the feeling that you get the pulsation feeling, and of course he gets the associated, you know, feeling that arises with an orgasm. But ejaculation is just the ejection of that fluid. Well, that fluid is going to be gone, again, because we've removed the mechanism of which any of that fluid can actually come out. So how does that feel? And again, a lot of it really just depends on the patient, but more times than not, patients will describe it as a more intense feeling actually when they reach orgasm. They just sort of say, wow, that was pretty intense, even though they're actually not seeing any fluid come out. Some men actually will have, you know, sometimes when their bladder neck will open up a little bit, some men actually have a little bit of fluid that actually will leak out as well, and they describe that as almost like having just a regular orgasm and a regular, you know, it's not, again, you're not, there's less fluid that's coming out as part of that too. Another question I get as well, besides that, is that sometimes they'll actually see some fluid, you know, kind of a sticky fluid that comes out when they're actually having intercourse. And they say, well, hey, are you sure you got the entire thing? What is that? And that's actually fluid that actually comes from the Cowper's glands. And the Cowper's glands actually release a small amount of fluid that basically coats the urine channel so that when a man ejaculates, that fluid can actually have an easy ride out rather than getting stuck on the sidewalls. So I tell this man all the time is that, you know, we don't go anywhere near the Cowper's glands. Those are lower on down, you know, from where we actually take the prostate out. But don't be surprised if you kind of see that sort of sticky fluid, you know, right at the end of the penis, you know, prior, you know, when you're having intercourse, et cetera, because that's related to, again, coating that urethra so that when a man ejaculates, fluid will come out. Well, guess what? If you've had a robotic prostatectomy, we're not going to see any of that seminal fluid come out because that's already been done. Okay, so that's already taken out. I think the other question, of course, is that will I have ejaculation or will I actually have any kind of fluid that comes out after radiation or cryoablation? The answer is you may, because on radiation, you're not actually removing the entire prostate. You're causing scarring tissue. You know, a lot of it really depends on the amount of radiation you get. For most people, they'll get maybe a small amount of fluid that comes out. For most people, a fair amount of that area has actually been destroyed. But again, you sometimes can get a small amount of fluid that comes out, you know, from a radiation-wise. And again, the same thing with cryoablation. But if we remove the entire thing, the ejaculation, for the most part, is totally gone. But again, sometimes you get that feeling of orgasm. You should be able to reach orgasm. And again, for my patients, they say, well, you know, sometimes, you know, I reach orgasm, even though I'm not at a full erection, even though I'm at maybe a 60 or 70% erection, I feel like I'm getting an orgasm like right away, you know, when I get stimulated, even though I'm not, whether I'm having intercourse. And the answer is you can get that, but again, a different mechanism in which that happens.
Some prostate cancers are high risk, aggressive, and more likely to spread. Others are low risk, least likely to have bad outcomes. The biopsy says cancer, but current diagnostic tools provide limited information about how aggressive a man's individual disease is. So most men decide to treat prostate cancer immediately. Once treated, many men experience serious long-term side effects, like incontinence and sexual impotence. Immediate treatment isn't always needed. But right now, a man can't be sure if his cancer is the kind that is likely to require treatment or if he's okay to wait for now. What if there was a test that could determine how aggressive prostate cancer is? Genomic Health is developing a new test to do just that. By reviewing the underlying biology of the tumor and using genes from multiple biologic pathways, the test can predict the aggressiveness of prostate cancer when diagnosed. allowing a man to make a more informed treatment decision with confidence, taking care of himself with more information and greater peace of mind.